What if you can make your apps do anything? And I don't just mean the boring stuff. I mean anything that the developers built into the app. Show me my YouTube dislike count. Summarize this video. Search the web for positive news stories. Zapier just unlocked the keys to over 2,500 apps. You're no longer constrained to pre-built actions. If you can type it, you can automate it. So as you'll see here from this changelog updated 5 days ago, they now support 2,500 apps for something called custom actions. Now, as Zapier is the largest AI orchestration platform out there, this makes for some very exciting possibilities. Take, for example, this real-world problem. I type in YouTube and I find the Zapier YouTube integration here. I choose from different events, but I want to see my YouTube dislikes. Now, I know it's available via the API, but you can see there are no custom pre-built actions to do that. Well, now you can build an action just like that using natural language only, and I'll show you how. So this is the custom actions interface, but you can also access it just by clicking custom actions. If the app is enabled for it, you'll see it here. And you can select create action. This is how easy it is to build a custom action. You just tell it in natural language, show dislike count on my videos. Hit enter. As you'll see here, just ask a couple of questions before it starts building. So I will say I want dislike count on only my channel videos. And then number two, do I have a specific criteria? Let's just do it by video ID. That should work perfectly. And with those instructions, the Copilot will go to work. All right, as you can see here, it's saying, here's what I'll do. Retrieve video statistics using the YouTube API. I want to say we really don't need to know anything about APIs because the Zapier Copilot is doing it all for me. There's that full self-driving car. I tell it what to do and it gets there. And look at this, this is insane. Done generating, and it's made some code under the hood, which obviously we can look at, but we don't need to. It says, all done, I've created your action, get video dislike count. And now look, we've got this beautiful action here and the ability to connect our YouTube account. So I've got my YouTube account connected for Creator Magic, and it's asking for a video ID. I'll just pop open my channel, copy the video link address, go back to the custom action I built, paste it in, strip out the URL so it's just the video ID, and run a test. And boom, there is the result. 28 dislikes on my latest video. Did I really not please you that much? So now I can hit publish, hop back into the Zap I'm building, refresh on custom actions, and there it is. Get video dislike count as a custom action. All built for me. I can select this. I can then connect my account as I usually would in a Zap. Continue to this. Test the step, and boom, look at that. 9 dislikes on that particular video presented as a result right inside my Zap. So now we've seen the power of custom actions in Zapier, let's build something even more exciting. I'm just going to click the back arrow to go back to my library, and you'll see this custom action is now saved in my Zapier account. Let's click create, and this time I'm going to use an AI. I'm going to use Gemini. Let's select it. And again, down here, we just tell Zapier what we want Gemini to do. Now, I know Google Gemini has the ability to understand what happens in a YouTube video, but it doesn't work out of the box. Look at this. I can add a step. I can search for Gemini in my Zap, add in Google AI Studio. For the message, I'll just say summarize video, and then we'll go over to the Creator Magic YouTube channel, copy the link to this video, paste it in, and test the step. And the result is in, and it says it's a CNBC Make It video, which I'm pretty sure my Build Your First AI Employee video says nothing about CNBC. This is infuriating because I know Google Gemini can view YouTube videos, it's just the general conversation endpoint doesn't allow it. So I'll now go ahead and solve this problem by asking the Zapier Copilot to summarize a YouTube video from only video ID. Okay, and rightly so, the Copilot is asking for some pointers before it starts. So 1, summarize, 2, public videos only, and 3 to 4 sentences, I think should be enough. Let's get it rolling. Okay, you'll see it's searching the internet here for API documentation. Now it's generating code from the online docs that it found. And look at that. Yes, all done. I've created your action, summarize YouTube video. So now all I need to do to test this action is obviously connect my Google AI Studio account, which I've already connected to Zapier, paste it into the URL here, and run a test. The suspense is killing me. And would you look at this? In one prompt, I've now got a YouTube video summarizer that works inside Zapier. Mike introduces Zapier AI agents, which he refers to as AI employees. This is absolutely spot on. And now I've just unlocked a superpower that I can use time and time again in my AI automations. Now back in my Zap, instead of this hallucinated CNBC content, I can actually go back, action event, custom actions, refresh, and suddenly I've got summarized YouTube video available to me to use in any of my automations. We'll go ahead and add one more action, and this time we'll pull in from OpenAI. tell me something funny that happened this week. We'll continue and we'll test the step. Okay, it's completed. Let's look at the result. I don't have live news access. And despite GPT-5 being really powerful, it can't look online. But I know when I go to the OpenAI API, it does have a web search capability. So Zapier Custom Actions should be able to figure that out. And for the prompt, I'll say allow models to search the web. Okay, it gets scaffolded under the hood really quickly for me, and I can test it out by asking it what was a positive news story from today. We'll just go to search the web custom action. We'll wait for that web search action to complete. And look at this using GPT-5's web search preview. We can actually see results here, including web links here to stargazers preparing for a meteor shower. Let's highlight this link and open it in a new window. And boom, look at this. Stargazers prepare for meteor shower of the year. And it is listing today's date, the day I filmed this video. So that is absolutely working. And if we go to my custom actions library, you'll see I now have a nice actions library of searching the web, summarizing YouTube videos, and also getting my video dislike counts. The possibilities really are endless with Zapier Custom Actions, and since just this week they released the ability to do this on 2,500 of their over 8,000 apps, you're going to have fun with AI orchestration and your favorite apps. Let me know what you're really excited to test out or create using this new copilot that can make things from natural language prompts. I'm super excited to learn more, and if you want to jam and jive and even share some of your templates, you should definitely join my community that's linked up down below. I'll see you in there. Thanks so much for watching, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.